BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency. Your Berks Craftsmen on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen.
You three. We're back! And in person. Yes, it is the Kutztown Folk Festival, July 2nd through July 10th. And I am Kay Bennecoff, your host here of Your Berks Craftsmen and a member of the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen. We are celebrating the return of the in-person Kutztown Folk Festival. And tonight, we are here. It is a party atmosphere, right, Heather?
Absolutely. We're ready.
Okay. We're here. I have Heather Zimmerman, the director of the Kutztown Folk Festival, and she brought several of her guests. It's a Kutztown family folk festival,
absolutely,
right?
You know,
and,
for sure.
And these are all members
family
of the family.
Yeah,
yes.
Long-time family members, absolutely.
Okay, so let's say we have Diane, mm-hmm. we have Keith, we have Bill, we have Eric, we have Dave, and we have Faye. And we have Heather.
And me. Okay.
So, Heather, tell us what's been happening.
Well, right now we are really, in the countdown phase. We're getting set up over at the fairgrounds. Lots of long days, you know, making it all happen. We're going to be, you know, recreating the festival that everyone has, come to know and love with a couple, new tweaks here and there. But we're excited. We're selling tickets. We're selling merchandise. We're trying to get everybody geared up in their shirts and tote bags and so forth to come to the festival. So super busy time, but super exciting time.
Yeah. Well, the response has been good, right, with your on-ticket sales, and stuff. And so they should get on the website and get those tickets, right?
Absolutely. We're encouraging, online ticket sales as much as possible to expedite people through our gates and get them there. Get them into the festival as quick as possible. We also are offering a special coupon online only, will not be available at the gate,
okay.
And that will be available Monday through Thursday to kind of encourage people to come during the week. And that is available online with the coupon code 2022WEB. And then that is a $3 off coupon. So
your ticket, $13. Say that again.
2022WEB. And that will reduce the ticket cost by $3.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. Well, people are so anxious to come back. The buzz is out there, and stuff. And I mean, okay, Faye, I just have to say this. I need that funnel cake. My tummy's been waiting for that funnel cake.
Absolutely.
Okay. So anyway, but you brought all these great people here, and they're just part of the festival, and they're going to share some things with us. But I think it's also important that everyone knows that everything that they remember from the festival is back. And more, right?
Mm-hmm. More.
You have been working your little tush off.
Everyone has. Really, it's really a group effort for sure. So, I'll give a shout out. Many of the people here have been so gracious to help us with so much. Me being a new director and getting this off the ground after not having it for 2 years. There's no way we could do it without all the help that we receive, and we're just so grateful as a team a very small team that runs the festival, but we gather our friends and family that, yeah. that have been to the festival, you know, worked at the festival yeah. and been participants for so many years, and they really helped drive the ship so yeah. and steer us in the right direction. I'm grateful for that.
Yeah, and it's family.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, should we start with Dave Klein down there? He is.
Sure. Let's start with Dave Klein.
Dave Klein, your entertainment, right? You know, and tell us about everything that's going on or going to be going on out at the festival.
Well, it's great to be back at the 2022 Kutztown Folk Festival with all these wonderful people. It becomes sort of a family reunion, and we've been missing each other for 2 years now. And that's just us. There are mm-hmm. all these vendors and craftspeople and patrons who come to the festival and who love it. So for my part, we're going to be entertaining them. Mostly I'll be at the main stage this year. And on the main stage, I'll be directing the main stage as a master of ceremonies, a manager so that the acts run on time. So if we have somebody that is really in the spirit of the moment, we need to get mm-hmm. the crutch and just pull them right out.
Give them the cane.
But also, to get people into the spirit and to welcome them, first of all, to our festival
yeah.
and to our family as you would if you had somebody into your home. This is the way I like to approach it, and I think many of the other people here do the same thing in their own shtick when they mm-hmm. work and interact with people. But if you come to the main stage, we will welcome you as family. We'll thank you for being with us, and then we'll show you a wide array of the great talent that represents all of the love and the folk and the traditions and the art and, of course, the music of the Kutztown Folk Festival and of our region and of surrounding regions. So it's an interesting collection of culture that happens at the main stage and throughout the festival. But speaking of the main stage in particularly, we will have Pennsylvanisch Deutsch music. We'll have music that's maybe more German in relationship to the culture. Then we'll have some other music like Celtic music that's also related. You know, in my dad's family tree, there was Pennsylvania German because he came from the Rhine, and but also Bavaria, and also he had Celtic blood in him because those Celtic folks were around long before the German tribes, and
right.
it's like it's all mixed in there, and it's all wonderful, and I guess some of these guys could speak about the art and the runic art and all that kind of interesting stuff and the symbols and the hexology, but at our stage, so we mix and present all that kind of wonderful fusion of music mm-hmm. and folk culture and traditions, and we'll have entertainers that are solo acts, we will have entertainers that are full-out bands, we have a klezmer band coming in again, we'll have bluegrass bands, we have country music bands, and as I said, we have the Pennsylvanisch Deutsch, and we have some songs, like I'll play a song called I, Katie Klutz. It's all about Kutztown's best schmutzer. Now, do you know what the best schmutzer is? Do you know what that means? What is a schmutzer? That's right. Kissing. Very nice. How did you know that?
Pardon?
How did you know that so quickly? She may
She's
be
blushing.
The secret Katie Klutz.
There you go.
Okay. So, and this song, and basically we teach people there that come to the stage, the audience, first, we loosen them up. We teach them to get loosened up. They're on holiday. They chose to spend their vacation day or their time with us in the summer with us and our family. So we want them to be relaxed, have fun. So I'll get them all chanting, you know, that word that everybody in Pennsylvanisch Deutsch needs to know. And Keith, what is it, those words?
Aye,
right. Aye. Something I heard my grandfather say all the time around the house. Helen, aye. That ain't right. So we'll have the whole audience chant. So let's pretend that you're the audience and I'm the guy doing this thing on the stage, because I am the guy doing this thing. And after me, please repeat the word I. One time. Say the word I.
Aye.
Now do it three times.
Aye.
Now you're Dutch. So it's the fun like that we have on stage. And also, I've been helping Heather and the festival committee and founding fathers, mothers, sisters, brothers, whomever, you know, to do some behind-the-scenes things that will, I think, increase the experience of the festival.
Yes.
One of those things that maybe gets taken for granted is every day during the festival, there's 9 hours now. So it goes from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. Mm-hmm. So there's 9 hours of the folk festival. So there's background music that plays on the PA system. I don't know if you ever thought about it, but I'm in the midst now. I'm in day number 5. If you count that out, that's 81 hours of music I'm putting together, all unique, but with a local flavor too. So I'll have guys, performers in there like Keith Prinzenhoff and Douglas Maidenford and our friend Michael Werner and his band from the Palatinate region along the Rhine in Germany. So we have a long reach of getting people involved. But I'm taking the recordings and I'm making this huge collection of music. So every day there will be 9 hours of non-repetitive music each day. Now, maybe a couple of the songs, the ones that are really important to us, that have the dialect in the base of the music, I'll repeat those because they're quite good and interesting and people would want to hear those. But that's all going on there around the PA system. And I was working on that this morning from about 8 o'clock till 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And sometimes I work on it late at night. Mm-hmm. And so just like other people, like Eric here paints these beautiful things. That's his art, that's his craft. My art and craft is music and communicating with people and getting people to feel relaxed, like I said. And then this unseen, unspoken thing where you'll be walking around the fairgrounds and I'm literally composing that music, putting that music together to elevate, to uplift, to engage people of all age demographics. Mm-hmm. So I'll have things that will be very familiar with people that might like music from the 1940s. I'll have music that people will like all the way through. I'll have music that children will like too, that will instantly ring a bell with them. So at least if they've heard one or two songs during the day that they resonate with and can sing with, and maybe mom and dad will have them dance a little bit to that, you know, they'll go home with a happy memory, and then they're going to want to come back. And they're going to want to bring their kids to come back. So that's all of my behind-the-scenes thinking and stuff that I put into it.
And so important.
I think
you're
going to miss that hillbilly version of Cannonball by Van Halen.
I can throw that in just for you. I can throw it in just for you. Yeah.
I think that's an important thing to mention real quick. You know, like Dave mentioned, and something that really humbles me so much is that, you know, these folks and so many others that are involved with the festival, are the dedication and the hours behind the scenes and you know, the preparation that's done. I had no idea just how much that happened, and it's just amazing how dedicated these folks are to making this visitor experience. It's a true memory maker, you know. Mm-hmm. It's memory making all over the place at the festival, and I think it's just very humbling to know that they do that.
Yeah, but it puts a smile on their face and everyone else who enjoys.
And so, I'll finish up with my part because there's so many other great people here. Just to say that our mission, our goal is to bring a smile to your face, make a happy memory, take some pictures, take some videos, you know, share them with your friends, and keep coming back and share the traditions that we share. In addition, those 81 hours I'm putting in behind the scenes, as you would say, for that music and all the thought that goes into that, I've made an effort as a composer and a singer-songwriter to write several new songs for the Kutztown Folk Festival this year that will be presented on the main stage, some live, some on the sound system. We've taken a local young boy, Owen Kutz, from Dietrich's Meats and Country Store in Hamburg, wrote a song for him. It's called Owen's Song. And I guarantee you, when you see this 8-year-old kid come out and sing this song, you got to be laughing. Yeah. You got to be smiling. You got to be wanting to hum along. Mm-hmm. It's just, it's hilarious. It's just like, wow, there's more ham in that kid than there is in the corner.
Yeah.
So consciously writing songs that will add to the folklore and traditions, because I guess my final thought is, we have some people who can't return to the festival because they've reached an age where they're incapable physically of doing it, you know? And so we don't want to ever forget them or the legacy that they left for us. So I think it's important in my point of view that while I can, to write some music and give some music to the festival. And my grandest hope of all would be like 20, 30, 40 years from now, when I'm not able to do it anymore, somebody does what we do. We play a song by the Fike family called the Kutztown Festival Reel. Okay, the Kutztown Folk Festival Reel. We carried on that tradition. Mr. Fike is long gone. And I'm writing these songs so that other people can sing and play these songs. Songs like the Kutztown Folk Festival Polka and Kutztown Folk Festival Fun and all these things that you'll hear if you come to the festival. And I'll tell you a little bit about them before we play them. So it has a real good impact. So that's my art and craft, what I bring to the Kutztown Folk Festival.
That's awesome.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you. Okay. So should we talk to Eric?
Sure, let's talk to Eric.
He's an interesting guy.
He is an interesting guy.
Let's talk to Eric Claypool, hex sign artist extraordinaire, barn star artist.
Hey, it's been a busy year. It's been a busy couple years.
Yes.
I'm glad the Folk Festival's back, and I'm happy to be here again. Yay! So,
Is it turned on?
There's a red dot on the bottom.
Is it turned on? Let's see.
It's hot.
Okay. Hi, honey.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's turned on.
Okay.
So I'm happy to be back at the Folk Festival. I'll bring a big selection of hex signs again. I'm still working on a whole bunch. And, you know, Patrick Dunmore wrote a book. I painted my 100th barn last year, so that'll be available at the Folk Festival as well. And, you know, with this little bit of war going on overseas, I decided to make a Ukrainian support design, which had the star with the Ukrainian flag colors turned into a sunflower. Butterflies represent a new life, a new beginning. So that's a new item that
that's
everybody
awesome.
Wants. And I had to stop and say, hey, you know, there's another one with a sunflower made out of a petal star.
That's beautiful.
And of course, we'll have the traditional Hill Stars again. Milton Hill was one of the vendors way back in the 50s, and this is his signature sign, the Milton Hill Star. So that's always a very popular one. I will have some ornaments. I'm pretty sure this says 2021, but Merry Christmas on one side with a distelfink or a rooster with a Santa hat, and a star of some sort will be on the other side, and they'll be hanging there. So we also have the normal welcome stars have been very popular over the years. The distelfink is the goldfinch, represents prosperity. Welcome, of course, means welcome. Hearts are love, tulips are faith, hope, and charity. So come see the stand. I'll have some 3-footers, 2-footers, 16-inch, 12-inch, possibly some 8-inch. I usually have them.
So you've been a little busy.
I've been a little busy. I did one barn already this year, and my friend who helps me at the Folk Festival, he'll be coming up from North Carolina, Andy Shirk. He's been helping me paint for 5 years now, and he's going to bring some of his own designs as well.
That's great.
So it'll be a fun week, and, you know, hopefully we have great weather. I'm glad to see the chicken stand is back, the big chicken stand. So, yes, and I will have my ghost projects.
I was going to say,
this has been outside aging since 2014. I brought it in last year. Okay. If you feel it, you can feel how the wood degraded around it. When I met Patrick Dunmore, we talked about ghosting for a couple years, is when the barn signs degrade on the barn and you can see the design raised out. Well, I figured it would take about 60 years for me to make one, so I decided to do half a star point and put it on a roof, gets full sun all day long, gets beat up by the sun and rain. That's on a piece of cypress, which I've been using a lot of lately. They age really nice. I've made a bunch of benches. Funny story about it. Somebody asked me about that at the Hayman Fest last year. I told them it wasn't for sale. And then they asked about a bench. I said, that's not for sale either. It's just for show. Why do you have it here? Well, she's like, how much would you take for it? I said, I wouldn't sell it for under $1,000. Well, I do the Folk Festival on Main Street. Somebody asked me about this. And then I tell them this story about these two women who, I don't know if I said beat me up over it, but I get a tap on my shoulder and she goes, that was me and I would have bought it if I had a place to put it. And I'm like, what are the odds of me being right here at the same time I'm telling this story?
Oh my
gosh. So it'll be a fun week. Looking forward to it. All the good food, drinks. Mm. It's a great family event. And hope everybody comes out and has a lot of fun.
Yeah. Very good. Very good. Yeah, but I wasn't going to let you get by without talking about
You know, they've been a very, very fun project. I built an outhouse in my field years ago, and Patrick put a thatched roof on, and it lasted for a few years until the March winds. And now it has 2 4-foot ghosts on it since 2019. So they're aging really nice. Maybe one day I'll sell them at the Folk Festival, but I'm sure we're going to be doing a Tower of Power, painting the hex signs, and auction them off again. So last year we had a ghost there that made a, you know, nice price for that one.
Good.
So it's fun, you know. I'll have a couple people working in my stand. We're all going to get up there and work on the signs.
I'll work on the
and,
stars.
You know, we'll have 4 ready for the quilt auction. When
so that's what I was going to say. That'll be ready for the quilt auction on the last Saturday of the festival.
Yes.
Not the first Saturday.
That's always a fun thing, you know, that Patrick started that. And
years
ago, Steve said, I better ask Claypool if that's okay. And I'm like, oh, that's an awesome idea, you know. And it's gone over really well. Yes.
And that is also being promoted now on our website. Mm-hmm. We didn't typically always have the barn stars, noted on our website with the, you know, associated with the quilt auction, mm-hmm. but this year we will. So
good.
That's another
yes.
thing we're trying to promote to get the word out there to everyone.
Yeah, so you...
Yeah, because they've gone for reasonable prices. It'd be nice yeah. to see them go for a little
yeah.
more.
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But whoever gets them gets a nice piece that has sure. usually four signatures on it. And
yeah, definitely a great piece of the festival.
Yes,
you know.
Yep. It's
yeah.
been a fun part since he started doing
yeah.
that. So, and we did it in my field 1 year, and last year we did it at the Heritage Center. And
wow.
So that's been nice.
Yeah.
But
cool.
come out and have some good food and mm-hmm. beer and crafts.
Oh, there's wine too.
And that's right. There is. Yes.
We'll yeah. talk about that. Right?
We do. We
can't let
selection.
Any of these great things, you
nope.
know, out because everything
not.
Is back. And then there's some new stuff this year,
mm-hmm.
right?
Absolutely.
You know, so,
but
know,
the funnel cake, I'll have to have one too.
Oh, yeah. We all have to have funnel
yes.
cake. Okay, thank you. Well, we're going to go on to
Professor Bill Donner, who is a professor at Kutztown University. And also, we shall we call him historian extraordinaire for the Kutztown Folk Festival.
That's what I called him.
Bill's very involved at the seminar stage and helping us in that area and getting people to do presentations and discussions. So,
yeah, and you learn a lot from it. Well, you
yes,
know.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So, tell us what we're going to learn.
Well, the seminar stage is the more academic aspect, mm-hmm. I think, of the Folk Festival. It's going to be a variety of events that are entertaining, but I also think are enlightening that people can learn from. The regular speakers will have people every day. Will include Kate Claire is going to talk about some old-time toys, and if people have been there for a while, Evan Snyder had some really great toys that he played with in the 1920s and 30s, and he made a really nice presentation about them. Evan was a professor at Ursinus College. He passed away, and his children gave us the toys, and Kate Claire
nice.
Is going to revive that, and I think that should be an exciting presentation. I'll be on the stage every day. I want to talk a little bit about the history of the Folk Festival and what's going on at the Folk Festival, and maybe if I have a little time, I'll talk about the history of the Folk Festival here. I'll also talk about schooling. That's one of my areas of expertise, Pennsylvania German education. So that'll be going on. Patrick Dunmoyer, who really is fantastic, a really fantastic scholar of Pennsylvania German culture and life. He's going to talk about, almost every day he's going to talk about hex signs. Now, I don't want to steal thunder from Eric, but Patrick's written really the leading book mm-hmm. about hex signs or barn stars. He's
yeah.
really the leading authority. And one thing I want to tell people, I don't know if you know this, you can buy a hex sign in or a barn star in Lancaster, but it's really not indigenous to Lancaster. Kutztown is really right at the epicenter of what was barn star hex sign mm-hmm. country. I always tell my students, if you draw a line from Vogelsville to Cabela's in Hamburg, go north of Schurth about 20 miles, you'll get hit about 70% of the hex signs that are there.
Yeah.
And Patrick's really the expert on that, so that'll be a great presentation. He's also the expert on powwowing, which is
yes.
the indigenous folk curing. And he has written books about both of those that are available. But he's really the leading expert in both areas. And he'll be presenting on the stage. Harry Serio, who's a retired minister, is going to talk about the Protestant Reformation and its influence on Pennsylvania Germans. Of course, something very important about the religious background of Pennsylvania Germans. And then we'll have some special events on top of that. We're going to have the German minister. I think one of the representatives from Germany is going to speak on Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
David Valeska, who knows, an expert on the Civil War and has written a book about the Pennsylvania Germans at Gettysburg. He's going to talk several days on the stage. We have a liars contest on the first Sunday and the second Saturday. And I see you all giggling. Actually, Liars Contest is a really American tradition. I don't know, you know, Mike Fink and John Bunyan. And traditionally, the story I heard was Americans would go out west and see big geysers and big mountains and big bears and come back and elaborate upon it. And this became a real kind of American folk tradition. Pennsylvania Germans were telling lies in the 1930s and 40s in Dutch. And so at the Folk Festival, we revived that. And they stopped probably, you didn't see so many of those by the 1980s and 90s, but we brought it back in the early 2000s. It'll be in Dutch and then in English for the audience. And then we also have a Schrijverfest, which is time in which people bring things they've written in Pennsylvania German. But again, that will be in translation. That came from a person who taught German in the Parkland School District, Ed Quinner. He noticed that back in Europe, there are all these different dialects, and they have festivals of these different, Flemish, but even, there's different versions of Germany still today in German. And he thought we should do that with Pennsylvania Dutch. So that's what we're doing. If I can just talk, one of the things I'd like to talk about is the history of the festival, and I'll try to be brief here because I don't want to take time from others. But the Kutztown Folk Festival actually has an important impact on academia, on the study of folk lore and folk life. It was first founded in 1950 by three people who had PhDs. And they were a lot smarter than me, and I guess they had better PhDs than I did. But William Fry was at Franklin and Marshall College. Don Yoder became the leading scholar of Pennsylvania German studies in the 20th into the 21st century. And then Alfred Shoemaker was really the leader. And what they wanted to do is have people present their own culture rather than have academics like me say, this is what's going on with these people. And it was a really innovative idea, believe it or not, have people display their own culture and have people come and see them. And that idea really took off. It actually affected academic programs throughout the United States. And I don't know how much you know about the Smithsonian Folklife Festival, which is held on the Mall every year. That actually was a spinoff of what Shoemaker and Yoder were doing. So we did have, a big impact on how people think about folk life and folklore. One thing I think actually, I don't know if you want to maybe cut this out of the tape, but ours is better than the Smithsonian's. The problem the Smithsonian has is they're bringing people from all over the world and plunking them down on the Mall for a week. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that doesn't work out so well. It's indigenous people from our area that you can see some of them here that we bring to the festival.
Yeah, so. Well, that makes us unique, right? Yeah. Gives the people that do come to the festival a chance to talk to the people who are from the area, and they can ask the questions and get the answers right from the horse's mouth.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, no, I think that's important that you said that. What did you say, Keith?
Better than from the other end.
I told him to bring good jokes tonight. Okay, that was pretty good. It's not possible.
You can let your audience know. He used to come on the seminar stage, but no longer.
He's been booted.
He's relegated to certain areas, and we know why, or we will know why shortly. No, thank you so much for sharing that. And then throughout the week, you will have different guests, at different times too, and sharing that. But you were talking a little bit about Patrick, and I know Patrick so well too, but he is such an engaging speaker, when he talks. I mean, if you think you're not interested, you soon are. You're like hanging on every word, because you learn so much, from him. And well, you learn so much from everyone.
Yeah, no, and the Heritage Center, we should mention, he can't be here because he's so busy getting ready for the festival, but they all have a display there right on the infield, which is always excellent. He'll be available if he's not painting to talk.
Well, the whole thing, Kutztown University, the foundation, the Heritage Center, and everything, it's just one big family, and it's all working together to put this festival together. And so, I think we have a unique festival and an opportunity that everyone should be taking advantage of.
Absolutely. Yeah, of course.
So, okay, I guess we'll have to go on to Keith.
Would you like to introduce?
I just feel like there's,
So next we have one of our famous, infamous entertainers, Keith Brinsonhoff, who is also helping us manage our hoedown stage this year. So again, another big help to us. So here we are. Keith.
Take it away.
Take it away. All right.
Who said that? Thank you very much.
I realize how difficult it is for people like us, Dave and Eric and Bill, who love to talk, to cut what we want to say down to a short amount of time. I'm trying to organize this, and I brought a bunch of notes here. Please, come think about it. I need notes. And I love working with Kay. You know, not only is she smart, but she's cute.
Oh, thanks.
Can I say that, or is that sexist?
No, I just love it. Keep going.
To us old guys, I was thinking maybe I could even call you a hot chick, but then some people would say, nah, that's a foul comment.
I said good joke.
Oh, well.
You did say that.
We'll be handing out the vaccines.
Yes.
So anyway, what I do 3 programs a day. First, at 10 o'clock on the Hoedown stage, which I'm also the MC and the stage manager there, with either Mike Herzog, who is a first place banjo finisher, I think at East Strasbourg Festival or someplace a few years ago. The other days with Kenny Garrett, who's played on the Grand Ole Opry. I played with Jim and Jesse, played for Roy Clark, yada, yada, yada. And so when you come here on the main stage, as well as Hoedown stage, you're going to hear some doggone good musicians. I mean, world-class musicians. And then at 12:30, I'll be on the kids stage. Or if anybody here or in the audience was ever a child, they can come hear me.
Absolutely.
And the songs are for the kids, the jokes are for the adults, that's what I always say. And then at 2:30, I'll be in the schoolhouse talking, explaining about Pennsylvania German language with accompanying culture and music and history and stuff like that. And we hope, talking with Patrick, we hope to be able to have a class at the Heritage Center this fall. I have to get it organized yet. I hope Patrick can get me some stuff before the festival, because I actually taught that about 8 or 10 times, different places. Mm-hmm. And I taught Pennsylvania German language with culture, history, music as a 3-credit course at Kutztown University. And Bill Donner was one of my best students. Okay, he was one of my students.
But his nose was getting long.
Yeah.
Yes, anyway, so I have a good background in the language as well as the music. And the instrument here is called auto harp. It was invented in Philadelphia in the late 1800s by a guy named Zimmerman.
All right.
How about that? Along with the other Pennsylvania German instrument, the only Pennsylvania German instrument in the world called the mountain dulcimer, which most people don't know about, and they don't know it's Pennsylvania German. But anyway, and I don't have mine with, I play it also. What else did I want to say? Dave mentioned one thing, a song we do when Kenny helps me in the morning, we do the Kutztown Reel. It was written by a man in the early 1900s in West Coastville. I have the original sheet music at home. And I love to do historical stuff connected with the music.
Sure.
What else did I want to say? Oh, there's too many things here. Think about it. My mind goes blank. A little aside here. I have to say hi to my softball buddies. I play senior softball every Tuesday and Thursday. And some of them are coming to the Folk Festival.
Well, all of them should be coming.
They should all be.
Some.
Yes.
Not some.
Fishing game.
Well, I'm tempted to say I'll play ball with them if they play ball with me, but usually that's never mind. I don't want to go there. But anyway, yeah, so I'll be playing this in the morning and on the children's stage also. And I've been working feverishly to help Heather out with local stuff and spent a lot of time there. And I appreciate Heather because she is so well organized and so friendly and easy to work with. I'll get my money later.
I did not. I was going to say.
Get my money later.
That's going to cost me.
Yeah.
More.
But, yeah, right.
But if you don't mind, I'll cut my speech here short if I can tell you one more story. Because we talked about Reverend Cirio. Reverend Cirio was my minister for many, many years, and we became really good friends. And usually I perform a couple of songs, Dutch or English, before the church services. But I can't do that this year because of the schedule. But back when he was minister, he was so good. One year, for a few weeks, one of his favorite parishioners, congregation members, didn't make it, and he found out she was sick. So he went to visit her one Sunday after church. He gets to her house, and he rings the doorbell, no answer. Knocks on the door, no answer. Opens the door, hollers in, Elsie, are you here? He hears her voice say, yes, this is Elsie. Who's that? He says, it's Reverend Cirio, Elsie. Are you okay? Elsie says, yeah, sure. Says, do you mind if I come in? She says, no, come in, sit down, make yourself comfortable. It'll take me 10 or 15 minutes, but then I'll be down, okay? Okay, so he goes in and sits down on the sofa, and now it's pushing noon, and he's getting hungry. He sees a dish of peanuts on this table there. He starts eating the peanuts. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 50 minutes. Finally, 20 minutes later, Elsie comes downstairs. And she says, oh, Reverend Cereal, I'm so glad to see you. I apologize for taking so long. You know, sometimes it takes me a while to get organized and made up and everything else. And Reverend Cereal says, no problem, I'm not in a hurry, but I have to apologize to you because I saw this bowl of peanuts on the table here. I was so hungry, I started eating them. I couldn't stop, I ate all the peanuts. Elsa said, that's no problem. Ever since I got my false teeth, all I can do is lick off the chocolate.
Okay, that was a good one.
That's a good one.
What can I say?
I'm going to give you up. And you will hear more of that.
We'll hear more of that, right? Exactly. More of that to come.
That was great.
Actually, we do want you to come to the festival.
That was good.
Did I ever tell you about our neighbor we got last year, moved into our neighborhood from Boston?
No.
Not?
No.
My God, I saw him last week. I said, so, you've been here since last year. How do you like living in Kutztown compared to living in Boston? He said, great, feels just like home. I said, what? Feels just like home living in Kutztown compared to living in Boston? Why is that? He said, well, because everybody talks funny and they hate the Yankees.
Okay, maybe not. Okay.
If you want me to play a song, I can play a quick song. If not, that's okay.
Well, I think we're going to have to let that pretty lady beside you talk,
yes,
you know, because she has a very important thing to tell us about, right?
So this is Diane Fallon, the quilt painter and watercolor artist.
Yes, and Heather was nice, and Cindy of the Quilt Barn had me do a painting this year of a quilt that they chose and the scene I chose, and it happened to be behind where we met and found out it was the Heritage Center.
Mm-hmm.
So I saw it on a January day, this beautiful barn.
Yep.
And
first one.
Went down, mm-hmm. took a ton of pictures, and was painting it from January on through March, 14-hour mm-hmm. days.
Yes, it's first one.
And got it done, and the quilt was really hard. They picked a really hard quilt for me.
We did.
So
challenge, yes.
Which I had a good time doing, though. It was really, really fun.
So this just to fill everyone in, this original painting will be raffled off at the Quilt Barn. So
yes.
We'll have three different raffle prizes available in the Quilt Barn. One will be the quilt itself that is pictured in the painting,
yes.
The painting, and then we'll have a wall hanging. So
awesome.
Tickets will be $5 each or $3, $4, $10. And I think we have that's an amazing special touch this year that I think people will really enjoy. So. The quilt is by Jean Jenkins and Cindy Hershey, who is our quilt director. She chose that for, it has like a contemporary color, but they said it's a very, she explained to me it's a very traditional design.
Yes,
so,
yeah.
And now it's in your beautiful painting.
It's a log cabin, they call it.
Mm-hmm.
Which log cabin is one of the oldest quilt mm-hmm. patterns and so many variations of that quilt pattern. And they picked this one, which was fun because the ones in between, the colors in between were the whites, but they also had texture and color in.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried to put that in there too. And the original painting is much bigger than the print. This
mm-hmm.
is a print of the original, but the original's about 22 by 30 inches.
And we
Heather
did get that
had it framed.
Mm-hmm. So
nice frame, which mm-hmm. I'm eager to see. And
And Diane, you're going to be in the Quilt Barn,
yes,
right?
Yes, I'll be in the Quilt Barn this year,
yeah.
And I'm going to do what I always traditionally do is demonstrate, which is, for me, the fun part of the festival. And one of the highlights of the festival, I think, for people to come to see is all the craftsmen, all the artists, we all demonstrate. We
yeah.
all do our craft, and it's so interesting for not only children, for adults, and I especially get a lot of the kids come around and they want to see what you're doing. And so I'll be doing that again this year. and I always try to finish or work on a new painting. Mm-hmm. And one of my new projects this year is I had fabric made. I got tired of the fabric companies not making fabric because of the pandemic. A lot of people weren't doing new things. So I found a fabric company in Durham, North Carolina, and I'm thrilled because it's made in the U.S. So I'm having panels done of all my different paintings.
Mm-hmm. That's and really beautiful.
Used for quilting.
Beautiful.
And this is one of my new paintings that I did, how to do some summer scenes.
Pretty,
so
really
I'm into
pretty.
The turtles. So I'll have different sizes of the panels. They can be used in quilts, they can be used in decor, t-shirts, whatever you want to do.
That's beautiful.
And with besides that, I'll have note cards too. I do note cards of all my paintings. And so I'll have lots of new prints, and I'm framing everything brand new this year. Some of my new framing is the quilt barn framing. It's more of a barn wood frame.
Yeah.
And I'm having new color mats, so I'm doing everything brand new in my booth. So it's gonna be completely different colors that I'm using. So I'm excited about having
We're really
that.
Trying to enliven the quilt barn as well, because we don't want, we lost about 5 of our quilters mm-hmm. in the past 2 years, and we need to introduce younger folks to that mm-hmm. Skill, that you
art,
know, gift,
yeah,
that art.
Yeah.
So something like this, you know, the colorful, you know, look,
yeah.
and your husband Barry has made us beautiful quilt rack samples that you'll be taking orders for, because mm-hmm. a lot of times people come into the quilt barn and they're not sure what to do with the quilt. They're,
mm-hmm.
you know, if I don't want to put it on my bed, what else can I do? So mm-hmm. we want to give them options. You could hang it, you could do this. So our staff will be there to kind of enhance that mm-hmm. Experience. And having Diane in there with her painting, and you know, actually being able to meet the artist,
yeah.
I think is really,
oh, yeah.
really special.
And I'm thrilled to be with the quilts, because almost every painting I do, I always say I'm quilting with my paintbrush. That's my main thing. Once in a while I stray away and I do maybe a flower or a bird, but it always comes back to the quilts.
So beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Well, Diane is one of our members, Reading Berks Guild mm-hmm. of Craftsmen, and several of our Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen help with the Kutztown Folk
Absolutely.
Festival. There's more than several of
more
our
than several.
Yeah, more than several of our craftsmen and artists that are there.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, really cool. And I'm glad you'll be glad you'll be in the
I'll
quilt barn,
be
because
air
it's
conditioning.
Air conditioned.
I'll be in the air conditioning.
I kind of feel I'll be in there sometimes too.
So but you all have to come see me,
so
because
we're
everybody
all a little
needs to come
jealous,
into the air conditioning.
You know?
So. Everybody
yes.
can see them, so I'll be in there to see everybody.
Not gonna lie,
I know you have to get into
yeah.
see
them. Yeah, right.
Oh, one of our coolers. Oh yeah, you can come see us too. Mm-hmm. We have this special cooler. So compliments of our daughter
All right.
and son-in-law. Mm-hmm. So anyways, that was good. Well, yeah, you know. Everyone's, of course, is always looking forward to the quilt barn for more than one reason, not just to cool off, but because of the beauty.
I'm so honored to be there. Thank you, Heather, and thank you, Cindy,
for
working with me, getting me
it's
there.
It's a really cool
really
idea.
Excited.
I love it.
Yeah.
I'm really excited.
So you did all this painting?
Yes. Yes, I do all watercolor paintings.
That is super neat.
Thank you. Thank
you. Did you ever try quilting?
No, actually, I did one block. I did for a company, and they had me do it for their book. Was one of the patterns from one of my paintings, and I got it back from them, they had redone it. So I failed at quilting.
Oh, so, she tried.
Yeah, I tried, and,
hey.
But I had to do it by hand because I don't own a sewing machine, so I failed at quilting, but that's why I quilted with my paintbrush.
That was their opinion.
I feel for you, because I tried quilting once, but it didn't go too well, just so-so.
So-so. I got it.
Oh. That was like...
I know.
Frizzling.
The one with the
Thank you, Dave. Oh, no. We're not picking on you. Yes, we are.
Yeah. Of course.
No wonder I feel like a banjo.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
I asked for that one.
Did
I? I did.
It never ends.
Okay. And last but not least,
we have Faye Heckman. certainly wanted to have our wonderful food represented tonight, because the Kutztown Folk Festival would be nothing without all the wonderful food. So Faye is with our Grange, and I see you have a funnel cake recipe here, so a couple notes here.
Oh, she
couple notes. So no, not the recipe. I think I was like just hoping for that, but yes.
Family secret. I'm with Virginville Grange, and we have been selling funnel cakes since the second festival. So we've been there for a very long time, our Grange. We are currently right next to the main stage, so I look forward to hearing a lot of Dave's music and the entertainment on the main stage. That's one of the things I enjoy about being out there for the week is all of the great entertainment on the main stage. These people are looking forward to funnel cakes. That is our signature dish. It is a recipe from Grange members Emma Miller. Her daughter Viola is the one who is credited with like introducing the funnel cakes to, I think it was Dr. Shoemaker, and getting our funnel cakes, getting those funnel cakes to the festival. So that's really cool. We make them from scratch. You will not find a mix in our stand. So we make them from scratch. You can stand at the front of the stand and watch us drop them from long-handled funnels while you wait. We also have corn fritters. They look like pancakes. And those are a traditional Pennsylvania Dutch thing. We have homemade shoe fly pie, mint tea, which you might also hear called meadow tea, and then some sausage sandwiches and some ham and bean soup. And then, of course, you know, other not quite as Pennsylvania Dutchy foods like hot dogs and hamburgers.
Martin special.
And Martin special, yes. That's a popular one. If you don't know what that is, come on out. It's a grilled cheese sandwich with a hamburger in the middle, a slice of tomato, and mayonnaise, and it's delicious. It really is. So I'm looking forward to a week at the festival, maybe not a week in the heat, so I'm Diane's gig in the pool. But yeah, it's a fun week. Again, it is a family atmosphere, you know. We see vendors come back year after year to get their ham and bean soup fix or their mint tea fix or their funnel cake fix. So it is a really fun week for us too. And I'm definitely looking forward to it. And you know, you guys stop by and we'll get you a funnel cake.
We'll get hooked up.
Yeah, and the Virginville Grange, and there's other granges out at the Folk Festival too. That's another big thing, right? You know, I mean, of all the food stands and booths and whatever that come out there, you know, and stuff. And that's a family affair. Grange is such a integral part here in Berks County, you know, of farm and family life, right?
I mean, I've been a Grange member since I was in junior Grange when I was about 7, I think, when I started. I'm a little older than that now. But I've grown up in Grange. My two children have also grown up in Grange, and they've helped at the festival at our stands for years. And it is, it's a big family affair. I'll have, you know, generations, you know, grandparents bring their grandchildren out to help and things like that. So it's great. It is, it's a family organization. And we look forward to, there are other Granges, there are other local
churches
and things out there with food. And for us, it's a great fundraiser, you know. So we look forward to that because we put a lot of money back into the community through community service. So it's a great fundraiser for us for that week.
You know, but you guys have a lot of fun doing it.
We
too,
do.
Because I see some of that stuff flying around. And I'm just going to say my husband loves your sausage sandwiches.
Oh, good. Good.
Right, Barry?
He's giving a thumbs up.
Yeah. Well, Heather, you have brought a lot of guests here tonight that have given us a bunch of information about the Folk Festival. Are there more things that we should talk about here, though, yet before we leave? I mean, I just want to remember the Celtic family,
Celtic Martin family.
Celtic Martins, because you were talking about them.
Right.
You, not about them, but they're going to be there. They have a big following. I mean, they're just they're a great family, you know, great music and dancing and everything, you know, and they really get the crowds going too, right? So they'll be back.
I think it's important to mention that Lester Miller is coming
back.
I think he is 87 years old, and he is back. And I just give him major props for that. I think, and you know, it's sort of like we have, what will the festival be without Lester, you know, and his dancers. So that's amazing. This year we have the Ringgold Band coming. Dave was very helpful getting the Ringgold Band there
so
on
popular.
Wednesday evening.
Yeah.
So entertainment-wise, and really every area of the festival, I don't think we can go wrong. The only other thing I'll mention is in response to some surveys that we've received over the years, people were asking for fresher food options, which, yeah. I mean, I don't really relate. I'm sort of like right there with everything she mentioned. I just would like to load up on that. But we do realize there's people who have some special dietary needs and you know, need to be conscious of that. So Fresh Fest Market is a little area across from where the Ox Roast is, near the College Boulevard entrance, and we'll have a couple vendors in there. Kutztown Produce Shack is in there offering some fresh salads and produce. Oh. So we have tray wood-fired pizzas with fresh homegrown basil and homemade cheeses, and Haven Farmstead. We have some wine. We have a distillery in there. So,
distillery.
That's all from the earth, you know. Yeah. So, yeah. But anyway, it's like in response to some of those comments, and just to try something a little different. So, Rachel Yoder painted a sign for us to use for the Fresh Fest as a contribution.
Oh, she's a great artist.
So it's like really a family affair. We're gonna give it a shot. We're gonna try. So it's one of the newer things, but.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's good to be healthy.
Yeah.
You know, a little bit that day.
Yeah, a little bit of health. I mean, get a salad and a funnel cake. It's
all about balance.
It is. You know, you're having a good
salad,
time.
Salad, funnel cake,
right.
Exactly. Mint tea.
There you go.
Virgin Greens is one of my favorite stands. I go there many times during the festival. I help support them a lot.
There's
always a couple old guys sitting outside who are always picking on me, trying to insult me.
Oh,
but she forgot one important fact about her location. Not only is it almost next to the stage, but it's right across the Beer Garden.
Yeah. And that goes really good with those sausage sandwiches.
I will say.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Definitely. Makes sense.
I hope Barry's getting your attention.
One of those old guys that sits outside the Virginville Grange has been to every folk festival.
Oh, yeah. that would make sense. Wow. Yes, yeah. Paul Miller.
Wow. So yes. The audience couldn't hear what he just said. What he just said was one of the guys that sits outside, like Keith was talking about, is Paul Miller, also a member of the Miller family, and you know they're all related to the Dietrichs and all that. So really, when we start out by saying this is kind of like a family reunion,
it really is.
And you got to come and be with our family while we're still here to be with, because some of our family members aren't here with us anymore.
Right.
And you mentioned Lester Miller. Lester's had a tough winter,
health-wise.
Sure. And I won't go into his personal details, but you know, I've been with him a lot and spoke with him a lot, and you know, thank God he's going to be there at the festival. And he loves presenting those hoedowns and dancing. So the same goes with all of us here. We're happy to be part of this tradition.
Well, you know what? I was going to say, we have just a few minutes. You know, we want to say about the website again, you know, and bring that up, Heather. And then, do you want to take us out with a song?
Oh, you said it with such a flourish.
Yeah.
How could I say no?
I think you know, we have 5 more minutes, you know, so if your song's about, what, 3.5, right?
Sure.
No.
It will be.
I'm just saying.
Okay, we will get my Kutztown, Pennsylvania German Folk Festival Americana hex sign guitar. Eric's hex signs right here. Handmade in Martin Guitar in Nazareth, Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
And Keith and I can play us out, right? He can play the auto. He'll play the auto parts.
Okay.
Can we do a song? Can I pick a song?
Okay.
Okay.
As long as you don't tell another joke.
Nope. Should be coming down to mind with Key of G.
Key of G. So now we're going to actually hear some Pennsylvanish Deutsch dialect, which actually we haven't thrown at you a whole lot.
Oh, okay.
And just to that point, too. So if I say Kunch de Mikafunga, what's the response?
One sack
of. Well, say it into the one time. Somebody say it.
One see Hokablaiva.
All right. Kunch de Mikafunga.
Made in Shubkari. Aha, I give you the ultimate answer. Huh?
Yes, now tell them what we just said, because it's makes
no
sense.
Can you catch flies, which people would ask our foreigners, visitors, to see if they understood Dutch. Why would you ask somebody to catch flies to see if they understand Dutch? So the answer is when they stay sitting, of course, that's obvious.
Yeah, and it's like a dialect thing, so I won't get long-winded with this, but there are a lot of dialects that come off of main languages. Sicilian being an Italian dialect, and it's the same thing. If you didn't know how to speak that dialect, they knew you were an Auslander,
right.
Somebody from outside.
Right, right.
Okay.
So I picked this song for one reason. You know, I was going to ask, should I do a song in Dutch or in English? How about if I do one in Dutch and English at the same time?
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to sing it in Dutch at the same time. Play it in English.
Okay.
Key of surprise? In the key of surprise?
Gee.
Yeah, okay.
As we go out, remember, come to the Kutztown Folk Festival, okay?
Yeah. Yeah, see, come from the body, once he comes. Yeah, see, come from the body, once he comes. Ja, sie kommt from the body, no, was sie mal gespartet. Ja, sie kommt from the body, wann sie kommt. Ja, sie fährt sechs Weißgala, wann sie kommt. Six white horses. Sie fährt sechs Weißgala, wann sie kommt. Ja, sie fährt sechs Weißgala, tell us your name is style. Ja, sie fährt sechs Weißgala, wann sie kommt. Ja, man schlacht an Elk und Hanna, wann sie kommt. Kill the old rooster. Man schlacht an Elk und Hanna, wann sie kommt. Chop, chop. Was sagt der ja gut Hanna, was fressen mit die Grana, ja, was sagt der ja gut Hanna, man sieht nicht. Ja, wir all hin hin und knapp, man sieht nicht. Chicken and dumplings, wir all hin hin und knapp, man sieht nicht. Yum, yum, wir all hin hin und knapp, man sieht nicht. Weil wir dick und fett, ja, wir all hin hin und knapp, man sieht nicht. Ja, man geht in a Sistena, man sieht nicht. Wir all go out to see her, man geht in a Sistena, man sieht nicht.
Yay! Awesome.
Muchas gracias, Dave.
Okay, so remember, July 2nd through July 10th, if you're not in Kutztown, get there.
Yeah,
right?
That's right.
Okay.
It's a direct order.
Okay, until next time. We'll see you again. Take care, stay safe, and good night.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency. Your Berks Craftsmen on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival, and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen.